Alright, so this is my Sega Genesis that has now been overclocked. We have four switches on the back. You got your European and American, Japanese and American, stock and 10 megahertz overclock speed, and the halt switch, which is required to switch speeds, otherwise you'll freak the processor out. We have gold-plated stereo audio output on this thing also, so that way you can have some good digital sound, you know, or not digital sound, but analog, but going nice to a nice amplifier. So I have this level here, because you remember before on my previous video, when you jump around in the trees, basically the game slows down really bad. This is stock speed. And you can see it's really losing it right now. It's like really going slow. So I'm going to get out of the trees. Halt the processor. Overclock it. And now unhalt it. Now we're overclocked to 10 megahertz. And doing the same thing. No slowdowns whatsoever. So now I put it back in stock speed. I'm gonna go ahead and put in my Everdrive, which the Everdrive is notorious for not really being overclock compatible. I'm gonna start it up directly in 10 megahertz. Now this is a game that doesn't work well with overclocks. This game actually is basically graphic corruption and freeze prone even at 8 megahertz overclock, I've found. It's very sensitive. I don't know if you heard it, but it just missed a beat on the music, actually. And you'll see all sorts of graphical glitches show up on the left side there. Little pops. So let me halt it. Now the music is still playing, even though I halted the processor, because the game's using the Z80 CPU to play the music. Early dual processing. So switched over to stock speed and unhalting. No more graphical glitches. Overclock. And it just made a little flicker, a couple of flickers. It's not an overclock friendly game. But what I do find interesting is even though the Z80 processor is doing the music, I'm not too certain why an overclock 68000 processor would cause musical glitches too. It's not the one doing it. So I don't know, maybe it's communicating too fast and it's messing up the system bus. But that's it.